in the pages that you have in the booklet. So I focused that it. I focused on it a little bit from the Kutei Tefillos. A little bit from the Kutei Tefillos. You know that Rabbi Nachman instructed Rabbi Nosson to make his Torahs, to change his Torahs into Tefillos. So we have the Kutei Tefillos. We have the Kutei Tefillos. And also the Kutei Halachas. The Tefillos of Rabbi Nosson, I know many of you use and many of you say, it's very, very big. This version of the Kutei Tefillos is according to the Aleph Beis, not in the regular Seder, but according to the different Inyanim. And since our journey is about connecting to the Tzaddikim and trying to reach out to Tzaddikim and ask them to reach down to us, so I photostated a little bit on page 16. And of course, afterwards, everybody will say some kibbutz tehillim, but we could try. But look at 16:7. We're going to go over 16:17:18. I'll read a little bit and translate. I mean, you know the translation. I'll read a little bit and we'll go over it together. The Kutei Tefillos, and then say a few kibbutz tehillim, and then we'll learn a little bit from the Kutei Halachas. So if you can look inside 16:17:18, for those of you who are not familiar with the Kutei Tefillos, so you get a little bit of a sense of what it's like. And my belief is that it's a big nachas for Rabbi Nosson that we come to his scene and that he sees people are using the Kutei Tefillos and we believe in these Tefillos and that we express our hakaras hatov to him for making Rabbi Nachman a rabbi for the entire world. So if you look on page 16, it's Ayis Yud Zayin. Again, I'll just read a little bit.
Ezra, and maybe over here, that is.
You have the booklet? Okay. Page 16. Just I want a little bit to see, and then we'll try to dive in it. Not going to stay here long. We have to get to Oman to stay a little bit. And on page 16, just look inside. We could even dive in a little bit together. I'll stop every now and then just to explain. On page 16, if it's Ayis Yud Zayin, you see on the left side, Uvechein Yehiratz Mufanecha. So I'll say Hashem's name. I'm going to be saying it by way of tefillah, and I'll stop every now and then. Uvechein Yehiratz Mufanecha, Adin Loi Lehinu V'lei Avoseinu, K'shem Shagov Rachamecha V'chasadecha Atzuma Malai. The greatest kindness that Hashem has done for any of us, for all of us, is that Barasa Isi Ben Zeri Yisrael Avadacha, that you created me, a Jew, Ben Zeri Yisrael Avadacha. So you had this Rachmanis on us. You had the Rachmanis to create us as Jews. From the whole world, you created us as Jews. So Nelson writes, Kein Yehmu Meyecha V'chaninasecha V'chasadecha G'doylem Alai. So too, may your chesed and your rachmim be so great with me. She'ezke l'shmoa heitev es kol divrei ha-tzadikim ha-amitim. May I be always zoche to be able to hear es kol divrei ha-tzadikim ha-amitim. The words of true tzadikim. V'yufkuchu einai v'yishmu oznai. That my eyes should open to see what the tzaddikim are telling me. V'yishmu oznam, my ears should be able to hear. U'levav v'yavin heitev is kol divrei ha-tzaddikim amitim. And my heart should be able to understand the voice of the words of the true tzaddikim. Asher oiskim tamid la'oirer u'lahalais es ha-toiv ha-nimshach mi'nishmais Yisrael ha-kovash b'golos. This is all I'm trying to go over and over this nakuda. Because the tzaddikim or iskim are constantly being Isaac la'oira, to awaken, or la'halus, and to lift up. As a toiv ha'nimshach min nishmas Yisrael ha'kavish b'golos, all of the good that's hidden in nishmas Yisrael were held in golos. La'asai is bala tshuva v'geirim. So that there can be true bala tshuva and true geirim, meaning those neshamas that are lost among the nations of the world should be able to return. Not that we're looking for new geirim, but the neshamas, of course, that are lost among the nations, Our children should be able to return to us. Ein kol divrei tzaddikim amitim shebedor hazeh, and to the voice of the true tzaddikim in our generation. Ein divrei tzaddikim amitim shechnei ofer, that we should be able to hear and to understand the voice of the tzaddikim who are already buried in the earth. Haksuvim b'sifreim hakdoshim, as it's written in this svarim. Ad she'eshma ve'era ve'ovin heitev, as divrei hakdoshim, ad she'hatoiv should be yisar b'sarikav gol. I should be able to hear the words of the tzaddikim to such a degree, to be able to hear it, so, until the point that the toiv should be the good that's inside of me, that elyonovi that's hidden inside of me, Yisaira should be awakened, the toiv of God with tremendous strength and energy. Until finally I'll have the strength by awakening this good within me, by hearing the true words of the tzaddikim, till I finally have the strength to be misgaber be'emes al hara. Not to just be misgaber for this moment or for this day, but be'emes be'emes, to be misgaber al hara. L'sharbro, to shatter and to break, l'garsho, and to push it away completely, to banish it from my life. Ulavatlo mimenu bebitl gomer. Ba'ifen she'eske loshu b'tshuva shlem lefenacha b'emes b'leiv shalem. Ve'eske liyos k'yotzoincha atoiv b'emes b'kdusha v'tarav v'simcha b'tuv leivu. V'chein yivosom v'fenelcha v'adonor lehini v'layav v'seinu. She'yifukach li or ha'seichot d'kdusha. V'nosan ze asking Hashem, and we're asking Hashem, that the light of my seichel, the seichel of kedusha, every one of us has a seichel of kedusha and a seichel that's not of kedusha, that I should be able to feel the seichel of kedusha, the light of the seichel of kedusha, shining within my mind. That I should be able to see the light of the true tzaddikim that's illuminating in all worlds. And how much more so we have to daven that we should be able to see the light of the true tzaddik all the way down in this low world. And because of the ugliness of our actions, uksilus da'atenu, and our foolishness, nistam v'nistam imenu erev ha'godl, the great powerful light of the true tzaddikim is hidden from us because of our foolishness and our aveiros. Adesha afilu kishonu nekfei, to the point that even when we're zeichim l'nizkar v'aleim, even when we're zeichim to try to get close to the tzaddikim, v'lasik b'sifreim ha'kadoshim, and we try to learn this svara, einonu zeichim l'hargish v'liras klal erem ha'tzach v'metzuchzach, we're not zeichim to really feel and to be able to see the pure light of the tzaddik. And we're not able to feel the pleasantness of the holiness of their words, because of the darkness of our intellect, of our minds, and our foolishness, and the filth of our actions. Because of this, the light of Yiras Hashem and Ahavas Hashem is hidden from us. Ad asher ba'avonoseinu anu rechoikim me'od mi'yirah ve'ahava amiti, is still far, far away from true fear and love of Hashem. Anu Adonai chamol aleinu v'al taz nicheinu v'al titcheinu. Please Hashem have rachmanis on us and don't abandon us and push us away. V'sa'azrenu l'hashlam is da'atenu l'zakenis ma'aseinu. We should be able to fix our minds and our actions. V'siftach lanu v'sor ha'daz d'kedusha. She'izgal lanu ha'emes. V'nizke lirayz b'nei sechleinu v'sor tzadika ha'emes. That our minds should be able to see, open up and see the truth of the light of the true tzaddikim. And may we become completely one with them. And to attach ourselves to their ways. All that they taught us. And we're tying this back together to the Bidditshva. I don't know if any of you realize that Rav Nosson, before he came to Rav Nachman, was a Talmud of the Kedushas Levi. He was a Talmud of the Kedushas Levi. And we're coming back to this Hisparus, to the Pe'er, the Hisparus, which is a very common thing in the writings of Rav Nosson. And look at the halachas, we'll see a piece in a few minutes. And he's asking that we should be zeichet to come close to those tzaddikim. Now, Rav Nosson is saying here, l'skar l'tzaddiki emes. He uses this term tzaddike emes. We love and respect all tzaddikim, but there's a madrega that's called tzaddike emes, true tzaddikim. And what's the simon of tzaddike emes, of the true tzaddikim? Sheyesh lehem koach legalos es godol ha'hisparus sh'atem esparim amchi Yisrael. The true tzaddikim have the power, the koach, the ability to reveal the tremendous hisparus, the tremendous pride that Hashem has, that He's mispora, the great pride, the great nachas that Hashem has. Im amchi Yisrael b'chal dar v'adar, with the Jewish people in every generation, because of Yisrael Hashem b'chai aspar, as it says in Pasuk, I take pride in you. Aspar doesn't mean take pride, I don't know how to translate. It's much stronger than that. The word pe'er, that I glorify in. I glorify in and take pride in my people. Hein bechlal mashat the mispar, im klolis Yisrael amcha HaKadosh, in general, the Jewish people, Hashem b'chata b'anim mikol ha'am, that you've chosen us from all the nations, where I'm planning mikol ha'lishayinus. Hein b'protius, but also individually, myself, the tremendous hisparis, the tremendous pride that you, Hashem, have in each individual one of us, the pride that you have. Even the lowest of Jews. These are the tzaddikim who are able to reveal this. Even the sinners of the Jewish people. Kol zman sheshem Yisrael nikrolav, as long as he's still a Jew. Atem mispar, you take pride. Umisgadol, umisroy meimboy, and you are exalted and lifted up through this person also. Behein beprote prote is mashpul mispar misnasi beprote hamaisim, and you take tremendous pride and joy. You mispar, you misnasi beprote hamaisim, and all the details of what we do. Vatnuas tayvis, that means that any tiny little tnuah taiva that we, any time that we move ourselves a little bit in the right direction. I said an interesting thing. I was talking a little bit on Shabbos. I saw something from the Imer Emes, from Ger Rebbe Swissilano. He was talking about the Saita. Last parasha and parasha's notes. He's talking about the Saita. And that's not the type of a person that you would think that anybody would be proud of. Her husband's not. And you know that there were Ede Kinoi, there were Ede Stira. She's not behaving nicely. There were Edom, his husband said in front of Edom that you're not allowed to go with this man, and she didn't. There were Edom that saw them in some private room together. And that's already not a nice thing. And Sof Kol Sof, of course, she, in this particular situation, the Torah tells us that she's tested with the Mayim HaMa'arim. And the result is that, Baruch Hashem, she did not commit any aveira in that way. There was no inyan of that magnitude that took place between them. Obviously, it was not a nice situation. They weren't going there to shmooze. It was not a nice situation. But she's innocent of committing that capital crime. She did not commit with him. And you know what the Torah says? What does the Torah say?
V'nixra
of an Israel. She's promised such promises that she's clean. And she's going to have children. Gemara says a boy, not just what, but every year, and he's not going to be short. He's going to be tall, and he's going to be healthy, and with money. But such promises that she's given. So the Imre Emes asked a very good question. Look, Mela, she survived this test. Okay, Baruch Hashem, she survived the test. That means that she did everything but right. She was there, and not only that, she defied. She went against her husband. And there were Edom, and the Torah makes such promises, and Hashem keeps His promises, and she's rewarded. She did a disgusting thing. It's not a proper thing what she did. She's not guilty al kedei kach that she did, but l'maisa she did a terrible thing. That's exactly what Rav Nosson is saying here. The Imre Emes says a very big chiddush. The Imre Emes says, could you imagine? She was already with this guy, that even though there was Edom, and she knew that her husband knows the whole parasha, that she's caught up with this guy. And that she goes in with him despite the Edom, with this guy. And everything. And b'shas maise, at the heat of that whole inyan that was developing between her and her friend, at that moment, what did she do? She said no. We can't assume that the guy pulled away. So she said, I won't do it. So the Imam says the Baruch Shalom sees that a Jew does such a thing. Gevaldig hisparus, that he makes such avtochas. In other words, when you're in the heat of that moment and you hold yourself back, that's what Rav Nosson is saying. Look at the words. He says, "V'hein beprote protes mashat emesporu misnazi beprote ma'isim hatnuas toiv v'shakol echem Yisrael." That woman, there was a tnuah toiv in her life. She was going in the wrong direction. She was heading downhill. It was really bad. And she was headed for a place of no return. Asula Ba, Asula Boral, she was finished. And at the last second, she pushed this guy away. And she says, I can't do it. So you would think a parent would not have his spires in such a situation. The parent would say, you're not going out of the house again. A parent would say, that, how could you have done such a thing? Is this the way I taught you? It's disgusting. How did you act that way? But the Imam says that the Torah says, the Baruch Shalom says, what an unbelievable thing you did. Now, of course, the whole stalshus, you have to work on this. It's not a good, don't let this happen again. But that you were able to stop at that last second and not to do it, that's called a tnua taiva, a good movement. When a Jew makes even the slightest, or not, there's a whole Torah in that, how in Shemayim, a tiny movement here, in Shemayim is a big movement. But Hashem is on his promise now. Beprote ha-maisim ha-tnuas taivas ha-kol echad mi-yisrael. Kol elu ha-espirus yizgilu ha-yidei tzadikai ha-emes. This is the tzadik ha-emes. The tzadik ha-emes shows each and every one of us and the Jewish people how Hashem is mispar in us. Pe'eru alai, pe'eru alai, pe'eru alai. What does it say now? Adonai Elohim Hashem Malach says, Monoisli, how's the sentence go? Unisiu Monoisli. Unisiu Monoisli. In other words, I run to him to take pride in him. Monoisli, but he also runs to me. And he sees that I run to him, and he sees that I try to become better. And this is what the Tzaddiki Emes are doing. This is the introduction to Rabbi Nachman. It's Rabbi Nosson, but on our way to Rabbi Nachman. These are the tzaddik emes, the Bedichev, the Baal Shem Tov, the Menosin, the Benachman. And through this are revealed all the Ritzainis that Hashem had in creating the world. Everything was Bishri Yisrael. Kadesha Tispur with his gadol with his roimim with his nase Aidei Yisrael Amecha. Then Hashem is lifted and takes pride Aidei Yisrael Amecha. And at the end, Aidei Zet is Akena Rachamecha Rabb Shigum Shachal in a year of Ahava B'Shleimus B'Amis. That through the tzaddikim opening this up in us, and through our being able to hear the voice of the true tzaddik telling us that Be'etzem were good, and Hashem is mispur in us. And to try to live up to Hashem's way of seeing us. Tis Akein Rachamech that we should be Zeicher what? For Yira, Vahava, B'Shleimus, Be'emes. Shinizke Lira, Shimcha, Adoda, Vahanoir, Lahava, Oizcha, Be'emes, B'chol, Vavein, B'chol, Navshein, and so on. This is Akein Rachasadach, Rabban, L'Shleimus, Adas, the Kedusha. That we should come to Shleimus, Adas, the Kedusha, to think like real Jews. To really, really be able to think like real Jews. And he goes on. Look at the bottom, Rabban Shlomo. Ata levad yadata oitzim rachmanu sheyesh lano akshe b'dor hazeh. Rabban Shlomo, only you know the great rachmanis, what a rachmanis it is on us in this generation. Akol amchi yisrael b'chlolis b'fradis, each and every one of us, kalechem yisrael. Ki akol chafetz miyir ha-shemecha. The truth is we all want to fear you. We all want to be close to you. V'akol te'evim, and everybody is longing, m'shtoikikim, u'metzapim, u'mechakim, l'skai v'lecha b'emes. And each and every one of us knows the wounds, the injuries, the damage that we've caused to our own hearts. But still, we're each mitzapu machakal, reifenemon manigamiti. We're on our way to Uman. We're longing and we're waiting for the reifenemon, for the faithful doctor, a true leader, manigamiti. That's what we need so desperately in our generation. She karav oisav yirape tachluve nafshu machal, that could bring a cure and a healing to the terrible sickness of and the pain that we're experiencing. Ve'ein mishi yamud ba'adeno. But we don't see anybody. Kill the kach demen of the next day. Machmed einenu. We've taken from us the beauty of our eyes. Kol ha-tzadike emes o manhiga mamitim. We don't have. Ve'estarte panecha mimenu. When you've hidden your face from us. The tzadik from us. Ve'ein lon lo manhig lo manahel amiti. Shiyuchel ha-hanigo sanu. So therefore, Marida Amakula, Master of the World, Atiyadatis Machaveinu, you know our pain. Res Takasenu, our screaming Shamata, Nei Naksenu, knows. The Naksen here don't have to be going that are beating us up. From the our own Taivas and Yetzaharas and so on. Kume Bezrasenu, Beis Tzarek Azayis, Bekvid Mashiach, Betoikiv Mirius, Golis, and Nefesh, such merivas, bitterness, of gullus and efesh v'aguf. Kein lo shum seichel v'das, eich lo ratzos l'fayisos. So we don't know how to appease you. Bech litmer oizcha shetoshif panecha eleinu. We don't know how to turn your face back to us. Avinu shebishamayim chamodol and avinu shebishamayim al tas tepanechim and don't hide from us. Moshe b'kol melech ha'kol ha'ar shlach lonu manhig u'moshe amiti d'kdusha. We're begging you to send to us a true leader. A moshe amiti d'kdusha. Remember, this is what we learn. What's a moshe tzadik amiti is to be able to reveal this nakuda of his pyrus. Sheyuchel ha'anig us and rachmem that he'll be able to lead us. He'll be able to lead us berachim. Now, if you look on page 21. We'll learn a little Torah, and we'll then recite some things. You able to hear? On page 21. I know everybody's standing in my hold. I'll try to do it very quickly, but it's a very beginning to learn the Torah, by the team. It's the same Nakuda. Quickly, on page 21. Al Kain Isa Bezara Kodesh. Levusha Diyu Lovish B'yayim Adal or Lovish B'yayim Achra. The levushim that he wears on one day, the garments of one day, are different garments from the other day. Levushim diyu lovish b'tzarfim, what he wears in the morning, will lovish b'ramsa in the afternoon. Ki Hashem yizbarach mispoyer, this is in the Hilchas Berachas HaMazon. Hashem yizbarach mispoyer b'chol eis, b'levushim chadoshim, anasim ayidei hiskarvus harachaykim, shemiskarvim b'chol pam, ayidei tzadik hadosh, b'chinas yosef. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is mispoyer, b'levushim chadoshim. What does that mean? It means that when there was a Jew whose whole life was acting one way, and he was wearing certain garments, that's nothing to do with clothing, but he was behaving a certain way, and then he's able to change his garments. He's able to change his ways. Alach has kama v'kama, if you and I know somebody, another Jew, and we're able to be makar of that person, or to bring that person to change his garments from what he used to wear. So, and to bring him close to the tzaddik, and this is the hal avod of the tzaddikim, ayidei tzaddik ador shu b'chinas Yosef. Because what's the Indian of a tzaddik? The Indian of a tzaddik is constantly changing, putting on new garments. What he wore in the morning, he's not wearing in the afternoon. In the afternoon, he's not at the night. The tzaddik always feels that he hasn't even started. I've explained many times. And that's why the tzaddik, Yosef, has such tremendous ability to be makar v'chokim, to bring them back to Hashem. Makar v'chol pam v'chokim Yosef. Why? Because the tzaddik himself is constantly changing. Constantly being makar of himself, closer and closer, and changing his own garments in Avodas Hashem. And because of that, since he's always starting again, l'haschil v'chol pam mechadosh, kilo maschil ata l'avodas Hashem. The tzaddik is feeling ki'ilu, the tzaddik always feels ki'ilu, he's just beginning now to serve Hashem. That's how the tzaddik feels. That doesn't mean that he's necessarily meeting those rechokim. It doesn't mean that he's necessarily on some kiruv outreach project and he's going out to see people. But by the tzaddik himself constantly changing and constantly beginning from Aleph, he's ma'orer other Jews. They might not have ever heard of the tzaddik. They never met the tzaddik. But it's ma'orer other Jews because the tzaddik is connected. The tzaddik of the generation is connected to everybody. And through the tzaddik changing his garments, the tzaddik being ma'orer himself, other Jews who are far, far away are drawn near. She has tchilu me'ata loshuv la'Hashem Yisbarach. V'akein, mitzadikim keilu yesh la'Hashem Yisbarach tanugim v'shashum v'esparus niflu b'choleis. If Hashem has tremendous pleasure and joy and delight, particularly from these tzaddikim all the time. Danu, hisparus chodesh, constantly new hisparus. Which is the Iker Esparus Canal. Kai Esparus Oyle Mechadosh Ayde HaTzadik Ba'atmush Mishchadish Mamish B'chol Eis. That the Tzadik is Mishchadish B'chol Eis always. Mosif Aholach, that's why Yosef HaTzadik, his name is Yosef. That he was constantly adding and changing, he was constantly different. Mosif Aholach Ba'avadosav Ayde Hiskarvus V'chaykim Shaboyim Chadoshim L'skarv L'avadosi Yisborach. And through the Tzadik doing that, many who are far away are brought near. It's interesting, when Rachel Imenu had Yosef, so we find it by Lei Imenu. So Lei Imenu said, "Pam oides Hashem." No, so I'm happy for what I have, which is a wonderful midah of Akaras HaTov. So that's the whole koach of Hoda, of Yehuda, of Mashiach Ben David, is that Leimenu says, Apam Aydas Hashem, even if I would have only this, I'm so grateful, because of course I was the fourth one, and so on. So she's grateful. Rach Leimenu has Yosef at Tzadik, and she names him Yosef because she says, no, this is not enough. Yosef Hashem li ben acher. I want to have another son. Hashem should add another son. Yosef Hashem li ben acher. This sounds a little bit funny. Instead of saying, I'm so happy, Eim habonim semeich, mamish, that you've given me, because I never thought I could have children bechlal. And my own husband said to me, Atachas alekim hanoichi. And that Hashem as well gave me. You would think that Rach Leimenu would have mamish, this would have been for her, this would have been, even if you gave me nothing else in my life, I'd be the happiest person in the world. Which of course she was grateful. But what came out from her mouth at that moment, and this is the way of the tzaddik, is Yosef Hashem li ben acher. Ben acher. Nochayid. Yosef Hashem li ben acher. All the tzaddik wants is that there should be other tzaddik. It's all the tzaddik lives for. Is that Hashem Yisboch should have aspirers from other Jews. And that I should be able to, Yosef Hashem li ben acher. And Rach Leimenu is saying is that I had a Yosef. She names the child Yosef because that from this child who Mirz Hashem will be a big tzaddik, Yosef Hashem li ben acher. It doesn't just mean for her, for Rach Leimenu, that she should have a lot of kids. It should be Yosef, it should be a tesefus of kedusha in the world. That through one tzaddik that comes, Yosef Hashem li ben acher. Yosef Hashem li ben acher. And therefore Rav Nosson explains, not here, but Rav Nosson explains how we see. How Yosef, it says, Vunar, as B'nai Bilal, B'nai Zilpa, right? He was, what does it mean, Vunar? It's a simple pshat, Vunar. He had a strange relationship with the brothers. There were the brothers, Mamish Leimenu, the children of Leimenu, and the B'nai Shvachis, right? Vunar, as B'nai Bilal, B'nai Zilpa, Rav Nosson explains that Vunar is that in order to connect to them, he made himself into a nar, the way we say it in Yiddish, a nar. In other words, he made himself into a nothing, into a nobody. You read a little bit about Rabbi Nachman's trip to Eretz Yisrael, what was going on with him, the Hunar, what he did, and all of the strange things that he was carrying on the boat, and then when he came to Eretz Yisrael, it reads like a novel, because it's too strange even to be a novel, but this is what Rabbi Nachman was Isaac in. And we can't even imagine what Rabbi Nachman was trying to fix, what he was bringing back. The purpose of his trip was the whole Indian of Mashiach ben Yosef and Mashiach ben David, and to be ma'ira this whole Indian of who nar is B'nai Zilpa. Who is B'nai Bilal B'nai Zilpa? It means the B'nai HaShvachas. Who are B'nai HaShvachas? It means people like us. And worse than us. A lot worse than us. B'nai HaShvachas means Jews that are like not in the highest place. I'm not speaking Hashon about anybody, but this generation, the people who are far away, the B'nai HaShvachas. So how are you makar of such people? That's Yosef's whole Indian. It's sad because the brothers hated him. And they didn't recognize him. Rehem lo hikiruhu. They didn't recognize who he really was. His whole Indian was the Hunar. So he made himself like a Nar. But the whole Indian of him making himself into a Nar was Yosef Hashem li ben acher, was that there should be other Yidden. There should be more and more aspirers that Hashem should have from his children. That Hashem speaks about us like a father who has an only son, or the Bechor, B'ni Bechor Yisrael, Bonamatan L'Shem L'Kech. Shul L'Shoinah Shachiba V'Hispirus, such L'Shoinah of Chiba, of affection and Hispirus. But Tzadik V'Ikka Klai Yisrael. The Tzadik is the Ikka of Klai Yisrael. Who Ba'atz my Nikra Bain. And the Tzadik is called a Bain. In other words, even though we're all Bonim, the tzaddik is much closer. Hashem omrei lai b'ni ato. Hashem omrei lai b'ni ato. U'machmas sha'atzadik mischadish b'avadosu b'chol pa'mi chadosh. And because the tzaddik is constantly in this state of Yosef Hashem li. And he's constantly adding, and he's changing, he's working on himself. He's starting again, the tzaddik. Because we don't think of the tzaddikim like that. We think of the tzaddikim that, like in all the stories that we read, that the tzaddik like has some special kaiches, and he started off when he was 9 years old or something, and then it's just, you know, he goes, and it's automatic. But Rabbi Nosson says it's not true. The tzaddik is maschem b'kol pa'am b'chadish, every time again, new, and new, and new. U'b'chol pa'am ben chadish eitzel Hashem isbaruch, and therefore Hashem has nachas, like every day, and that he's comes a new child. B'chinas Hashem omar lai b'ni ata, ani hayom yiladetich, sh'atzadik maschem b'chol pa'am b'chadish, kilu noylet hayom. Right, there's that. Hashem is brought mispar. Well, b'chol pa'am michadash kilu yilado hayom ki'ilu hani hayom yiladetich ki'ilu. He was born that day, which is, by the way, That's what Rabbi Nachman's uncle, who we were just there today by Baruch Meshbitzer, the Rabbi of Baruch Meshbitzer told that over to Rabbi Nachman by his bar mitzvah, that the inyan of the bar mitzvah is ani hayom yiladeticha, today, ani hayom. So the whole inyan of Rabbi Nachman is hayom, the kolos ishmo, ani hayom yiladeticha. In other words, the bracha to every day should be hayom. Beginnis bni at ani hayom yiladeticha. Ze beginnis yoisa v'shem li ben acher, shatzadik mevakish v'chofetz tamid, shashem ishbaruch yoisif lo'i ba'atzmoi ben acher. The tzaddik is talking about two things. The tzaddik is talking about other Jews coming close, and the tzaddik is talking about himself, Yosef Hashem Li, that I myself should be, from today to tomorrow, ben acher. I should be like a different person, from today to tomorrow. Yosef Hashem, help me to become tomorrow a person that is not the same person that I was today. Da'ayin she is chadish v'yasch b'chol pam mechadish, v'avadosi yisbaruch ad she yenechsha b'chol pam, Ben Acher La Hashem Yisbaruch Ki Ben Chodesh Anoy Le Hayoyim Bechines B'ni Ato Ani Hayoyim Le Neticha. She said Bechines Mailas Hazok and Hagol Mikulam, like one of the explanations of why he was called the Yira Kodesh. That's a different neighborhood, the Yira Kodesh. But why he's called the Yira Kodesh. So one of the reason that's brought out in most of the Makaris is that the Yira Kodesh, every day, it was Ki'ilu, he just became a Jew that day. So he was called the Yira Kodesh. Every day it was like he just started that day. And he says, Shezeb Chinez Mailas Azokin, Hagodl Shemekulum, he's talking about, I'm sure that many of you read the story of the seven beggars, Hamuva Ba Maise, of the seven bedlers, Shezporah Shu Zokin Ma'oid, where there was one of the stories, Hezporah, there was the one who was Mesporah, that he was showing off, so to speak, he was taking pride, he was Mesporah, that he's Zokin Ma'oi. He said, I'm the oldest person, I'm very, very, very old, but what? Vuyanik Ma'oi. But I'm a little baby. Va'adayin lo hischil lichyos klal. I'm very old, but I haven't started living yet. That's the tzavi. I'm very old. Nar hayisi, v'gam zakanti. It's the same thing, zakanti, nar hayisi. The gamma idezesh at Sadig Moisev Mishadish Babadosu Masr Bukhal Pamechadash, Ideze, Humakar Bukhal Pamechaikim Lashemizbach. And by the Tzaddik working on himself in this way, of Yosef Hashem Li Ben Acher, and constantly being Moisev Mishadish himself, many Jews who are far away come near. Velo Arachaikim Shad Sadig Makarvim Lashemizbach, Hemdekorim Banim Esel at Sadig. And these are like the children of the Tzaddik. He called him Alamid is Ben Chavero Torah Kilo Yilodo, because when you teach another Jew Torah, either directly or indirectly, it's kilu you gave birth to that person. Zeh gam ken b'chinas Yosef li ben acher, she yiska b'chol pam l'karev echem yisrael michodesh, l'Hashem yisbaruch shehu ben acher. So it's also a tefillah, Rabbi Nosson says, we're davening that we should be able to bring other Jews, that all of us should be like this, to bring other Jews to our own avodah, to bring other Jews close to Hashem. Ben chodesh is a ikiris parusi yisbaruch, k'mo yishuvinu etzor avenu zechar levracha. So Rabbi Nosson says, like we saw by Rabbi Nachman, the main simcha that Rabbi Nachman would have was when another Jew would come and become part of the chabura to learn and to be miskarv l'Hashem Esbach. When there was somebody new that would come and be part of the chevra and would begin with this avoda, that was more precious to Rabbi Nosson than everything from the past. Ki ikar espirusu, ki sha'ul espirus chodosh la Hashem Yisborach, aide eskarbus arachaitim kanal. Zebuchinus ha-Mahadrim, and ha-Mahadrim, he puts all of this into the story of Hanukkah, but obviously we understand that the inyan of lighting Hanukkah candles is Yosef Hashem li ben Acher, because the whole din is a din to be Moisef ha-Harlach, to add. And bechlal, that the whole story of Hanukkah, which we read about during the parashiyos of Yosef and Tzadik and with his brothers, and the din by Hanukkah of Mahadrin and Mahadrin mina Mahadrin, and the word Hadar bei Hadar lehadar means to come back, to return, to come back, to bring Jews back to Hashem Yisbarach. Mahadrin mina Mahadrin, to bring back. The hider espirus to espirus who bechinas moisef for hadar bechinas yosef bechinas atzadik she moisef for hadar chol maschil ba'avadosu mechadosh b'chol pam. She says the ikar espirus that the tzaddik starts again to light the candles, nochamal, nochamal, and he adds, and he adds, and he adds, and starts again, and he adds. Means to bring something new into the avodah Hashem. That's what chinuch is. That's why we use education with the lashon of chinuch. Chanukah is what shemischanich echad mechadosh umaschil likanis ba'avodas Hashem. When somebody begins avodas Hashem, that's called chinuch. And ze ikris parusi is baruch. That's the ikris parus that Hashem is baruch has. Look at Yud Beis. So this week is the parasha of Baal Oischa. Mitzvah Hashem, you know, it's a soul talk a lot about that. By Baal Oischa, but we're holding by Baal Oischa. So let's just end this little piece now. The Zebuchinus, Zeb Maisa Hamanaira, Mikshazov, Ad Yirecha, Ad Pircha, Mikshahi. So, you know that the menorah was very, very complicated, very beautiful, and there were many, many pratim of how it was made. But the din was, of course, that it has to be Mikshahi. It has to be one piece. You also have Tommy Vin?
Yeah.
I said, I'm not English now. Okay. Okay. Said, Tsuichin Lios Akshan Godel Ba'avodas Hashem. Tsuichin Lios Akshan Godel Ba'avodas Hashem. Rabbi Nachman said, you have to be very stubborn. If you want to be an Eved Hashem, you have to be a big action. Misha Hischil Ma'at Ba'avodas Hashem. And anybody who ever tried a little bit to be a real Eved Hashem, not Stam, you know, but to be a real Eved Hashem, Yodea Zos knows this. She'i Evshel Lios Ish Yisrael Be'emes, you can't be a real Jew, Kim Aidei Akshonus Godel, only if you're a big action, stubborn. Stubborn is not a good translation, everybody knows an action. Ki Harbe, why? Harbe Harpaskois V'Aliyois V'Yeridus, oh, when a person goes to be, wants to be an Eved Hashem, Harpaskois means like adventures. Goes through a lot of ups and downs, adventures, all kinds of things. Elias and Yeridus. Shvichin larva kol echad ve'echad bli shir. Of course, if you're not trying to be an Eved Hashem, then the biggest adventure you have is like an adventure land or something. But if you want to be a real Eved Hashem, the Elias and the Yeridus and the Harpaskos and the Menias, it's a mamish back and forth. Kol echad ve'echad bli shir. V'en lo yeh action godel. And if a person is not an action godel, if you're not mamish, if you're not mamish stubborn, an action godel, I just got, you know. I'm trying, and I was nechizik, but so far I'm not doing like a list. I'm clean for almost a month, Baruch Hashem. I don't eat from drugs. I eat from soda. I'm a person that's addicted to drinking soda for the last 40 years, 3-4 cans a day with caffeine, and my wife has asked me, and the children have asked me for many years. And I'm even afraid to talk about it, Baradim, because I might fail again. I started this project twice before. And,
huh? The keychain?
Keychain? 30-day
keychain.
Oh, the yeah, to be clean. So I, to be misspoiled in that. And I've tried in the past. And so this is what happened. So Chani was over from Baltimore with Shirley. And I have such a hanok because they're telling me, oh, we're so proud of you, that we're so proud of you. Like, you know, they do what I try to do with them. Give me positive reinforcement. They're very proud of you, daddy. And they get me different color flavored seltzers, you know, pink grapefruit, Perrier or something. And we're so proud of you, daddy. We're so proud of you. My wife is saying, he'll never do it, he'll never do it. My kids are saying, right? That's what I'm saying. But my kids are saying, daddy, it's gewaldig, it's gewaldig, it's gewaldig. They try to buy me different flavored seltzers, you know, and all these things, and chizik, and the akshanas. So then I was walking with Shuli to shul, and so Shuli was saying, daddy, it's really a great thing, you know, you really got to keep it up. And I said, you know, mommy said that it's not such a big thing if on Shabbos I have a now, I wouldn't get a bottle, the 2 liter. I would get just a can, you know, can, whatever. And to have by Friday night a can, and by Shabbos morning a can of soda. And so Sully just, he stopped walking and he said, no, that's not how it goes, Dad. He said, that's not how it goes. I said, but yeah, but mommy said I could do that. I could have a can Friday night. Just a little Coke Zero, just a can. You know? And In the airport lounge, I was looking, they have those little baby ones. I caught my eye. So, I'm just like, I have a kid. So he said, listen, he said, Dad, you know, I have chaverim from yeshiva, guys that got seriously like addicted and stuff, alcohol and other stuff. And the only way that you could, the only way to really get over it is if it's like just not part of your reality. It's just, you just have to be in action, like totally out. You can't do that Shabbos, because then it becomes part of your life. It's still in your life. You can't do it like that. To be an Eved Hashem, of course, it's only a marshal, but to be an Eved Hashem, you have to be an action goal. Big action. Because you start something, and it's such a Yetzirah that when you start something, page 22, that you start something, it's to keep it up, to keep it going. Like in learning, when you have a project in learning, or in either sumerara, say type, it's very hard. The hardest thing is staying with it, is keeping with it. I wanted to do this also because even though I know we're not moving to Eretz, we're just going there for a couple of days in Eretz. But maybe it's a service in our lives to follow this order. Rabbi Nelson and Rabbi Nachum were filled with an ahava, a love of Eretz Yisrael. You cannot don't see by the other Talmidei Baal Shem Tov such an ahava to Eretz Yisrael like you see by Rabbi Nachum and Rabbi Nelson. The tefillos of Rabbi Nelson got by Eretz Yisrael, and Rabbi Nachum's whole inyan with Eretz Yisrael. That he said Lashonis like everything that I have and everything that I am is Eretz Yisrael. Very, very strong Lashonis you don't find by any of the Talmidei Baal Shem. Even though there were those that went, of course. But we don't find such a stoikikus for Eretz Yisrael like by Rabbi Nachum and Rabbi Nelson. Such a stoikikus for Eretz Yisrael. So it's a befratlin serve a love of Eretz Yisrael. And everyone knows it's a befrat when it comes to moving to Eretz Yisrael. She says, Ikke Kedushas Isha Yisrael. You hear what Rabbi Nelson says? Do we have a tissue or something? Ikke Kedushas Isha Yisrael. Because the Ikke Kedusha of a Jew. The Ikke Nitzachen HaMelchama. And the main nitzachim to be victorious in the milchama, k'mashakosiv rabbeinu zochon lebracha about Torah Tisha Tikune Ayin Sham, v'adi iyev shor lenatzeach milchama zoyz, kim ayde akshonus gadol ma'ayb. Right, that goes back to what we had in the bus, because you can't win. So over here it says, v'adai says you can't be mitzeach. It's right that you said you can't be mitzeach the milchama, kim ayde akshonus gadol ma'ayb, unless there's big akshonus. The Iker Aspirus Hashem is Baruch Mispora be Yisrael. And that's the Iker Aspirus that Hashem is Mispora be Yisrael. Because Hashem is Baruch Mispora Ma'oid Baha'azus Vahakshonus Shal Is Yisrael. The Baruch Hashem has tremendous Aspirus. In what? In the stubbornness, in the Akshonus, the stubbornness, the Azus, the Chutzpah of a Jew. Shal Isha Yisraeli Shema Pilon Yisrael Bechal Pam. That even though he's smashed down every time, he starts again. Who mischazik b'chaleis? Who action God? He's mischazik himself. He's a big action. When a meniach lahaklatzim b'shum oif, he doesn't let them push him away. The ikis parusa is baruch. Bechinis tnu oiz lokim a Yisrael gavalsa. There's a pride that Hashem has. Oiz bechinis azus v'akshonus. The azus and akshonus of a Jew. Shem azim mechazokim avadosun shaydeze. Ikka kavalsa tayr who klal aspires. That's the ikka tayr is to be an action, and this aspires that Hashem has. So now we're trying to focus more. And this aspirus that we were talking about before, Kama Shomar Vesenez Achmel Levracha, and they man in the Torah Yisrael, Chazal say, why was the Torah given to us? When they say an Azim, we have a lot of chutzpah, akshonis, Azis. Adeze, Al Yisrael Gav also, Hashem's Gaiva, his pride is with us. Dainu Geyus Vespirus, Kiza Ikis, Parusius Baruch, Kama Shikosuk, Tifers, who is on the Otto, Ki Ikis Pirus, who ha Azus Vahakshonis. The main aspirus that Hashem has is the Azus and Akshonis of a Jew. Through that actionus, each and every one of us can be zoichem be'emes l'natzeach ha'melchama, to be victorious in the melchama. And ultimately, to be victorious means that it's in Golus, you really can't do that. It's a global Eretz Yisrael. So it's ikir nitzachin ha'melchama. Ka'idei ha'azus v'akshonus u'ikir espirus ha'idei nimshach kedushas Eretz Yisrael. Because through that midah, which we're going to be talking about by Rabbi Nachman, Eretz Eicheles Yoshevel. We're going to learn a Torah from Rabbi Nachman that the Midah of the Jews of Eretz Yisrael, I mean, Yosef doesn't fit into this so much because he's so ugly, he's so fine. But the Midah of Eretz Yisrael is what? Shtar. Very, 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 very shtar. Very strong. Akshonis and Azus. No? Israelis. Azus Akshonis, right? Okay, there's Azus Akshonis Ikris Params. Azus the Kedushan, Akshonis the Kedushan. Right, there's a Nimshach Kedushas Eretz Yisrael. That through that, by being that way in Chutz Laaretz, we're able to connect Eretz Yisrael, because that's the Indian of Eretz Yisrael. Ki Ik Eretz Yisrael, Ayde Yisparos Kanal, Zebekinis Hashem Olof Geus, Levesh, Levesh, Hashem Oiz Yisazar, I know Iker Levush Gavos of his Moses Baruch Hu Aydeh Azaz Hashanah She Yisrael the Bechinas Lova She Hashem Oiz Yisazah, and this is the Azaz that brings us closer and closer to Bimenetzech Nemochama and to come to Yisrael, go all the way to the end of the next page where it says Zeh Bechinas Zeh Ma'ase Hamenorah Mikshazal, and that brings us back to the parasha and the menorah. Ma'ase Hamenorah, what's the Ma'ase Hamenorah? It has all these beautiful intricate little fancy parts and pieces, right? So the Ma'aseh Menorah is a bechinas klal hisparos Hashem has brought mispar b'Yisrael shemisham ikar ha'or kanal. Then we know Chazal tells that Hashem says, "Look at the Jewish people; they make for me a candles; they light up for me a place." And Chazal says Hashem has brought needs light; he needs to be. Hashem is light himself. So what does Hashem need us? He needs us to make candles for him. But you see that Hashem has brought is like that. That what that he says you make candles that's. So he says mispar ikar ha'or kanal. Okay, therefore, B'neiros HaMenorah, Haya Eidus Hashem Yisbarach Oyev Am Yisrael, therefore Chazal tell us that the candles of the menorah in the Mishkan of Mishan Mikdash was Eidus, that Hashem Yisbarach loves Am Yisrael. U'mashish Shechinoso Behem. K'ma Shomer Vesem Zechon Levracha, Al Nir HaMarabi, Shu Eidus L'chol Boi Olam, to the whole world, that what? Shesh Shechinish Rabbi Yisrael. Shesh Bechinis Espirus, Shemachmash Espirus Yir Aroso Bonu, U'mashish Shechinoso Besechenu, Nimsa Shekol Ma'is HaMenorah, who begins to aspire with? So Hashem is brought from aspire with. So the whole Ma'aseh HaMenorah with all of its intricate pieces is what is to show Hashem's hisparus with each and every different Jew. Therefore, he says, "Zebchinas kol hatsiurim the floim shahiv menorah." That's why the menorah had all these amazing, beautiful siurim. The way that it was made was so magnificent. All these details. Shahiv menorah givim and the kaftarim mishukadim and prachim and so on. What's all of that? What is all of that? Why do we need that by menorah? Kol zemrames al kamamine gvone hispirus shal Hashem Yisbarach mispar b'Yisrael klulim migvone segin. Because the menorah shows, this menorah that shows that Hashem is mispar in the light that we bring into the world, and each and every one of us. So therefore it has all of this beauty. The menorah is made as a work of art with all of its intricate details because Hashem is mispar. And he has all this sparrows from all the different colors of his people, all the different types and ways, all the little things that we do, all the tnuas toivas, all the things that we try to do, and all the little, even the way Jews talk, and I always talk about that, the little things that we do, and the way that we live, and the way that we act, all of this makes up the menorah into something which is a work of art. Shir's Baruch Mispar Bizo Klumi Gon, the Chol Eilu is sparrows, and all of this is sparrows. He says, Shem Bechinas Maisa Menorah Ein Zeichen Kim Ayidei Akshonus Gol. So the Akshonus is what? Miksha Achas. That's why the menorah has to be an action, mixture. I don't change. One shtick, ein shtick. That's it. That's who I am. You can't change me. Ein zeichim adi action is God. It's tzrichin liyos action God. What is Hashem? Zebuchin v'zei ma'ase hamenorah mixture is zohar. Mixture is a loshon of what is hard. Action is tzrichin liyos as kosher. But is Hashem action is God ma'oy. So ad yureichad pircha mixture he. And shakol at siurim va'prochem shuv menorah. All the beautiful flowers and the things by the menorah. Ad yureichad pircha. Shehu klal hisparos shal Yisrael. Apol zeichen. How we zeichen to this? Aidei akshon is dafke. Beginnes ad yirecha pircha mikshehi miksha. Haynu shebechol avaydus ish Yisraeli mitchila va'ad soif mitchila va'ad soif. Shemikulam akabel Hashem Yisbarach hisparos shu beginnes ma'ase hamenorah kanal. As a nasara zena calls nasara aidei akshonus. Beginnes ad yirechan so nas de akshonus. So beginnes mea ma'ase Hashem Yisbarach mishabech is Yisrael. Zos kamosach domsilus omer dahinu shem chazokim koshim betakifim avadosim. They were strong mikshachas akshanim. And then he says in Yudal, v'zeh b'chinas v'oilach eschem kamimius. Has this connected coming back to Yisrael? So he says, that's what it says in the pasuk. V'oilach eschem kamimius. I'm going to bring you back to Yisrael kamimius. Kamimius, kamimius, in such a way. Standing tall, upright, but kamimius means shtei koimais, like Gemara says in Bava Basra. Kamimius, pirish Rashi, but koimas kufa, action, miksha achas. Kizeh mikra nemalin in Eretz Yisrael, because this pasuk is talking about Eretz Yisrael. It was just a couple of weeks ago. Shalashom hayu holchin Yisrael, All of the wars that we have to fight, and all of the journeys that we have to take to try to get back Eretz Yisrael. Everything that you and I are going through in our lives, with our own Yetzaharas and our own difficulties, to conquer all of that, it's all on the way to Eretz Yisrael. It's all part of the conquest that brings us ultimately to the place of the Nitzach and of Eretz Yisrael. And this is the meaning of Oilech Eschem Komimiyas. That's what it means, Komimiyas. It means a Jew doesn't bend down, a Jew doesn't kneel to anybody. Komimiyas, Miksha Achas, action. That's what it means to be a Jew. We have to be that way in our own avodas Hashem. We have to be that way vis-a-vis our enemies, vis-a-vis the goyim. Everything. Kamimius. That's the way to get to Eretz Yisrael. Kamimius. Miksha achas. Azus. That's the way to get to Eretz Yisrael. Ki iem shalov leitz Yisrael ulenatzeach milchama zois. You can't possibly do it. And to win the milchama, she ikka klav kol milchama shkol ishi Yisrael, which is all of our struggles, all of our battles. And therefore the Kahanim, or the Balabatim of the Beis HaMikdash, the Kahanim wear clothing, which is everything, all beautiful, different, intricate clothing. It's all L'chavod or L'sifaris. It's all L'chavod or L'sifaris. Because the whole thing of the Beis HaMikdash is that all different Jews, each one with his own Melchamed, each one with his Melchamed, his own Akshonis, is able to be zeichet, to be mislabesh, like we started at the beginning of this Torah, that the garment that's worn in the day is not worn at night. Each and every one of us is mechadish kedushim, na'avodas Hashem, with akshanas, to change and to grow. And in that way, Kadosh Baruch Hu is mispar, he takes the greatest pride in each and every one of us. We hear by a tzaddik, the whole inyan in this world was to be megala, the hispirus that Hashem Yisbaruch has with each and every one of us, with Am Yisrael, to bring the beauty of the tzaddik to the world, the Yofi and the Chain, which Rabbi Nachman said, that Al-Molay, if not for my Nasim, Rabbi Nachman said such strong Lashon, he said, it's a Tmiya Gedoyla. If the world would understand what you and I have, this Inya, the world couldn't believe that there could be such a thing as a Rebbe in a Talmud like this, as Rabbi Nachman, Rabbi Nasim. The world can't believe that there's such a thing, wouldn't be able to understand such a thing.
Why aren't they buried together, Rabbi?
What's the Hashgacha Pratzer? Rabbi Nachman, Davka wanted that he had to be here, and Rabbi Nachman had to be there in Uman, and he had to be Rabbi Nachman. Rabbi Nachman had a cheshem for being. The question is, why isn't Rabbi Nachman buried in Breslau? If that's Rabbi Nachman was the, that's where he was Isaac. Then a short time before he was Nifta, all of a sudden he had the zinyan to go to Uman. Rabbi Nachman, the tikkun that Rabbi Nachman was making in Uman are very, very deep, very mysterious, and we'll talk about it a little bit over there, but it has to do with what happened over there with the Kiddush Hashem that was in Uman. Rabbi Nosson's avoid is a different avoid. Rabbi Nosson's avoid was not to be caught up in that whole lineage of the vitzichas that took place in Uman. Uman is a place of massacres, of Jews being killed, al kiddush Hashem, in large scale. And the union of Rabbi Nosson, that was not Rabbi Nosson. Rabbi Nachman saw that in that way he had to be there, and Rabbi Nosson had to be here, to make these two tikkunim, which are the tikkunim of Mashiach Medav, Mashiach Ben Yosef. Hashem is Moshe Nehelta, we should be taught to go back from Yisrael saying.
Amen.
Can you go back to the bus?
No.